We've got Pat here beside us, and today we're going to be doing a summer organization video. So summer is upon us. Oh, Pat really wants to come into the camera. Today we're going to be doing a summer organization video. Every time when a new season starts, I like to get onto my organization just a little bit because it helps me to get the most out of each season, not just enjoying the time that I have in each season, but also to stay on track of the goals and the focus where I would like to be at the end of the 3 months. So today we're gonna be doing three lists and we're gonna make it colorful. We're gonna stick with the summer theme. So we're gonna make it really fun and beautiful. I've been using this tool notebook for so long now and I really like it because it's customizable. You can take out the pages and put them wherever you would like. That's so important for what we're doing today because I'm going to be putting the three of the pages that we're gonna be working on. I'm gonna put it right at the front so it's there in front of my face for summer. So I'll link the blank pages that we'll be using for this particular project as well as the notebook itself down below so you guys can check it out if you haven't ever heard of this notebook. It will change your life, this kind of organization system. But basically we're going to be making three lists and the lists are going to be one list, the goals for this summer. So for instance, I have on the fridge, I have my bucket list basically, and I'm not going to put up all of that stuff in there because there's no way you can do all that in one summer. So you're just going to stay focused on the parts that you would really like to be working on in the summer. So you're going to take one or two things from that bucket list and put it onto your list for your goals. But primarily my goals are things I have to do, errands and things I have to buy. I just recently moved into this new place and actually I'm really excited today because I finally put together the media center and that was a huge project and it was complete and I only lost a couple of hairs. I'm gonna hang the TV a little bit higher. And then I've got big plans for the top of that media center. I'm really happy about how that turned out. So basically we're gonna do goals and that includes purchases, things that you want to do. And the second page is going to be things that you absolutely love. And this is really important because it helps you to really hone in on the things that you love, right? Throughout the summer, you can have all the things that you really enjoy. Things that we absolutely love. It could be anything. It could be a hot shower. It could be warm clothes getting out of the dryer. It could be anything. The simplest of pleasures actually are the best ones. And you on one of these pages, it can be either or. You're gonna wanna put all the food, the recipes and stuff that you're gonna wanna try. And this channel is going to be featuring a lot of new recipes. So definitely stay tuned for that. And then you can add them to this list. So basically as I'm going through Pinterest, I might see a recipe and I might modify it according to how I like to eat. I will add them onto my list to make because otherwise I'll just never get to anything. The very last list is going to be the habit tracker, and the habit tracker is really important for the habits you're working on right now. So I'm working on green smoothies and drinking water, and I try not to add too many hobbies in all at once. Ideally you want to master one habit and then move on to the next habit, and then therefore you're not being overwhelmed with all the habits that you have to be adding. But at the end of this year, I will not be having to do a habit tracker anymore because basically all the habits that I want for a lifetime are already going to be worked in, so I'll be good to go. We are going to do a summer theme today. We're going to do a watermelon, basically a fruit theme on one page. And then on the other one, we're gonna do a geometric theme. The last one, we're gonna do a flower theme since I'm all about flowers. If you guys have been following me on Instagram, you see all my flower pictures. You don't have to go out and spend a fortune if you have markers, colored pencils, if you have acrylics, watercolor, even ink. You guys know I like writing with fountain pen. You can use the inks that you have and dilute it and use that as a sort of watercolor as well. So you can use anything you've got on hand, any type of color, even color crayons. You can use anything, even makeup. Just kidding. Let's not get too expensive here. So the first thing is I cut out this cardboard. You just need an Amazon box and cut out a square. And that square is going to go, I'm gonna tape it down really lightly. And so when I am, you know, I'm painting all across in white, it's not going to get in the area that I would like to keep blank so that I can write my lists. So what we're doing is we're just working on the perimeters for this particular project. We're just working on perimeters. And I haven't done any of this before, so we're just gonna wing it. But you know, I have a really good feeling about this. I have a really good feeling that this is just going to come together and pop. You wanna know what's really funny is Pat is on my easel and she's just camping out, living the life. So I got these containers where you can put like cotton pads and Q-tips and stuff like that. And then I got them in the mail and I could have swore they were just those little ones that you could just store, you know, bathroom products. And they were huge. They look like they're straight out of Aladdin. I felt like I was living in Aladdin because they were just like buildings. So, you know, I had to use another use for them. I had to put my bath bombs and now we're just using this as, we're using this as paint water. Would you like a glass of wine? You know, those paint and wine nights. This is like, this will keep you. One of these days I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna have a glass of watermelon water or something like that in that big a cup. It's gonna look so hilarious. We've got our Palea plant right next to us today. And that plant is my favorite plant of all time because it looks like pizza leaves. So if you guys don't have enough room for a fiddle leaf fig tree in your house, then you can get one of these because I feel like this is a baby fiddle leaf fig tree. The fiddle leaf fig trees have the big dark green circular leaves and these have the baby green leaves. I like the look of circle leaves. That's why I have that pearl plant outside. I'll link the Palea down below. I got it online. So I'm just making this into one orange. I kind of want it to be big and bold, you know what I'm saying? I want it to be big and bold, like my summer. So this blueberry is not to scale, but you know what? This is fantasy. This blue ink is just so beautiful that I've got big plans for this blue ink because this is going to create some beautiful pieces. I just can feel it. I feel like there's another fruit I should be adding around here and I can't even think of what that fruit would be. Man. So my oranges turned out looking like apples, so I'm gonna make an orange just because I'm going to create a little tangerine instead. For my goals themselves, I'm gonna write them in pencil for the main reason that I want to be able to cross them off or erase them if I have to. So I'm gonna write the goals underneath here in pencil. Only the titles I write in ink. Goals at the top, and then I put doing, getting, cooking, because that's gonna be the three categories of my goals for the summer. And I put little clouds around them. If I do add more goals onto this list, then it's only going to be at most double this list. So this is the perfect amount of space in the center so that I have enough space for all of my goals for the summer. And I'll easily be able to cross these off in one season. So I'm gonna keep this at the front of my notebook because it will really keep me on track for where I would like to be heading and really accomplishing a lot of things that I would like to be doing, just the loose ends, you know what I'm saying? Because the place is almost set up. The place is pretty much almost set up. So it's just basically loose ends of things that I would like to be doing, and that is going to be easy to accomplish just in the summer alone. That's gonna be so easy. I'm gonna close it in and smash it down. So tonight it's gonna flatten out because it's going to be smashed down with all the other pages. So it'll get nice and flat. So I'm just gonna keep that in there and smash it over. Smash it, Pat. We're gonna smash it with this brick. Okay, now we're gonna work on the second page. This next lesson is gonna be super easy because this is going to be the habit tracker. So it's gonna be very straightforward. And there's not a whole bunch of habits I have going at once or else they're all going to fly off the handle. What I'm gonna do for this one is I'm gonna make it geometric because habits are like building blocks, right? Once they get into your system, you don't even need to think about it. So I'm just gonna make this one so easy. This is gonna be so easy to make colorful. Just gonna make it into Lego blocks, basically. Pat is really liking the smell of those colored pencils. Does it smell like the forest, Pet? Are we having a nap in there? What's happening? Pet's just a little camera shy. Oh, I am liking how this one is turning out, man. Guys, this is really vibrant. Vibrant yet clean looking. I don't think I have a yellow marker, so I'm just gonna use a yellow color pencil to get this on the board. We gotta have some yellow in here. These are the building blocks for success. You know, I like this page so much that I might end up putting this one at the front because it looks so vibrant. It just looks so good. I think I like it more than the fruits one even. We have the habit tracker with my top habits and priorities right now. I might actually keep this one on the fridge, but regardless, this is just a great list and a great reminder. And I love how those stained glass kind of window, you know, like mosaic, it just pops. I love that theme. I just think it looks vibrant and clean looking. Our last list is going to be the things in life that I really enjoy. So the things that I really want to remember for the summertime to get out and just enjoy and really pay attention to. Oh, I like that dark blue. Well, that's a nice dark blue. I think I want the dark blue. Okay, here goes nothing. This is going to be a cluster. Okay, got these loose flowers. And I definitely want to use that violet, that blue, and that baby pink because they're all super, super pretty. When you're doing roses, just keep some space in between the petals so that it doesn't look so cluttered together. When you're painting or cooking or anything like that, I think the best advice you can ever get is to be vigorous, to be never gentle, because you're not going to get good color payoff. These are so pretty. They're glittery. When the sun hits them, they're gonna sparkle like there's no tomorrow. I love the way this one turned out. It looks just like stationery. I feel like the flowers look really classy and add a beautiful border and stuff like that. So, guys, give this a try. Get your list in order for the summer and you will not regret it. So I really like the way these turned out. You can even put ice cream cones or, you know, barbecue or something like that around there for the summer. There's so many great ideas that you can try. I like to make it colorful, pastels, you know, you can do pretty much anything that you can think of. And your list will look, you can put it at the front and there you have it. It's all set. It's basically all set so you can wake up. Why not make your habits and everything else so much more enjoyable and colorful? Your notes and everything. I just think that adds so much joy to life. So I hope you guys like this video. If you guys did, definitely give me an upvote and also add me on Instagram because you will see these lists in action. Not on the page, you'll see them in action. So add me on Instagram and I'll see you guys there. Thank you guys so much for watching.